Who is the enemy? We've been talking for 24 weeks now about the warrior archetype, but the question kind of remains, what war are we actually fighting? I mean, who is the enemy that we're fighting against? Now, in 1939, 1940, 1941, there was a real enemy out there that we really had to pick up an M1 or get into a B-17 and fight that enemy. And there have been times since then when there's been a real enemy where we really have to be real literal warriors. But in the realistic world that we're in today, that's not really the enemy we're fighting. So I'm asking the question, and I'm going to answer it for myself. Who is the enemy? The enemy is up here. The enemy is inside us. The war we're really fighting, and that we need to have the warrior virtues and the warrior archetype for, is the inner war. Now, what does that mean? I know I've talked about that before. I'm going to try to get into a little more detail here. I want to read you a quote from my rabbi, Rabbi Mordecai Finley, who's an amazing guy, half Irish, half Jewish, former Marine, son's a Marine, and is also a PhD in ethical philosophy. He's a kind of a guy who I would call a sage, a real sage. And at one point I was writing a book about the inner war. I wanted to get Rabbi Finley's take on this. So I took him out to lunch and I sat a tape recorder on the table and we talked. And this is something that came out in the middle, verbatim. There is a second self inside you. He didn't mean me specifically, he meant everybody. A second self inside you, an inner shadow self. This self doesn't care about you. It doesn't love you. It has its own agenda and it will kill you. It will kill you like cancer. It will kill you to achieve its agenda, which is to prevent you from actualizing yourself, from becoming who you really are. This shadow self is called in the Kabbalistic lexicon, the Yetzer Hara. The Yetzer Hara, Steve, is what you would call resistance. That's resistance with a capital R that I've talked about in my book, The War of Art. Now let me talk about that for a minute. If we exist on two levels, which I believe we do, if we exist on the material plane, where we live here, and if above us is the higher plane that we aspire to, that we want to raise ourselves and elevate ourselves to, in between those two planes is this invisible, insidious force that I call resistance, that Rabbi Finley calls the Yetzer Hara. And its goal entirely is to shut us down, to cut us off from our nobler self, and to prevent us from communicating with that self and from becoming that self. That, to me, is the enemy. Now, if you have a dream, if you want to write a book, if you want to make a movie, if you want to survive a rough patch in a relationship, if you want to be a great mother to your children or a father to your children, if you have a dream of starting a nonprofit foundation that will promote peace or whatever it is, what is stopping you is this force. And the form that it'll take is that voice in your head that will tell you over and over again, you are not worthy, you are a bum, you are a loser. How dare you even think of this dream that you have? And this force will also take the form of fear, of self-doubt, of arrogance, of complacency. And this is the enemy that we are fighting in the inner war. Now let me talk, I've tried throughout this series to really stay away from politics, and I'm gonna do that now too, but I wanna make one point here. Partisanship and tribalism are definitely dominating the political scene in America today. And if you're on the right, you look at the left and you say, oh, those are the bad guys, the terrible guys, that's the enemy, that's who we wanna fight. You're on the left, you look at the right, you say the same thing. They're the bad guys, look at them, blah, blah, blah. Now, I'm going to make the case, and I believe this completely, that if you or I find ourselves looking outward and discovering some enemy, quote unquote enemy, that we think we need to fight, alarm bells should be going off in our head. Because what's happening, that's a completely false narrative. What's happening is, we know that there's a thing that we should be fighting, that we should be overcoming inside our own heads. And we know on some level, on some deep level, that we're not doing it, that we're not living up to our nobler selves. We're not fighting this enemy. We're not confronting it. We're not being warriors. So what do? We project that enemy outward to some devil that we imagine is our enemy, and then we take up arms against that devil. And that, to me, is what's wrong in our country right now. Now, we've talked before about how we evolve as human beings from archetype to archetype, and that the warrior archetype, that's kind of an earlier archetype, is succeeded by higher archetypes, the father or mother, the mentor, the teacher, the king, the sage, and the mystic. And as we evolve to those higher archetypes, as we mature, one of the things that happens is our point of view goes from being ego-centered, as it was in the warrior, which is a kind of a us versus them of necessity point of view, to something that's much more inclusive. And we start to be able to identify with the other, with the people or entities that we believed were the enemy. And we start to see them as they truly are, which is human beings exactly like us. They love their children. They want the best for the future. They're struggling with inner turmoil themselves. They love their wives. They love their families. They believe in their country. And when we start to have that inclusive attitude, then we realize that this partisanship is a bunch of BS, and we're really just projecting our own cowardice and our own failure to face this inner foe onto somebody else and then fighting them or pretending to fight them. Which brings me back to something we talked about earlier in this series, and that is the Hindu scripture, the Bhagavad Gita, which, if you remember, I'm going to refresh your memory, takes place on a battlefield where the great warrior Arjuna in his chariot is looking across at enemies on the other side, and he sees kinsmen and teachers and people that he knows, and he says to his charioteer, "I can't fight these people. I love them. I care about them. Nothing good will come of it." And his charioteer turns to him and reads him the riot act and says, "Those people, you must kill them without mercy." And his charioteer happens to be Krishna, in other words, God in human form. And the kicker of this whole thing is when Arjuna, the great warrior, looks across at these enemies on the other side, and he names them, and they all have actual names. But the trick is that in Sanskrit, the names that were chosen for those enemy are also the names of vices that we have inside our own heads. Their names are arrogance, complacency, fear, self-doubt, and so on and so forth. So that when Krishna is telling Arjuna to slay those foes without mercy, what he really means is slay them in your own head. Slay those enemies inside yourself. And to me, what is really fascinating about this concept is we have two archetypes. Remember, we talked about archetypes, king and warrior. In this case, we have the warrior archetype, the great warrior Arjuna, being instructed by the God archetype, by the divine archetype. And what he's telling Arjuna when he says, fight this inner war, the goal of fighting this inner war and of overcoming these enemies within is union with the divine. In other words, starting from the material level and reaching to our nobler and higher selves. So this is my conclusion here, and I offer this to you for what it's worth. The real enemy is the enemy between our ears. It's the enemy that stops us from becoming our nobler selves and our higher selves. That's the war we have to be fighting, and that's what the warrior archetype is there for.